Okay, I've got my sketch in Photoshop. I've got it cropped and formatted the right size as we did in the last video. Now I need to set up my layers correctly and paint. After cropping, it put the sketch in layer 0. Okay, so I'll name this layer sketch. I'll try and keep my layers organized. Good practice. I'll double click on the name there and call it sketch. Okay, I'll need two other layers. To create another layer, I can click on the new layer icon. I can go to the options button there and do new layer. I can go to the menu and do new layer. I won't tell you this every time, but there's multiple ways to do the same thing in these programs. So I'll just hit the new layer icon here, and it will just default to layer 1. I'll double click on it, and I'm going to call this white BG for white background. Okay, and to move this background on the bottom, I just click and drag. Oops. To move it to the bottom, I just click and drag. Notice it highlights blue. Okay. And that's ready to go. Now I need to fill it with white. So I'll go edit, fill. Notice there's a key command for fill. It's Shift F5. So I can just click on this or hit Shift F5 when I want to fill next time. Click on that, hit white, because I just want a white background. I can do other things, but I just want white, and I'll hit OK. So now I have a white background, okay? Because the reason why I'm doing that is because I still want to see the transparency grid every once in a while. So if I click on the eye here and hide those layers, okay, you can see the transparency grid is there. But as soon as I show the white background, you can't see the transparency grid in the sketch. All right, the third layer that I need is the paint layer. So I'll hit new layer again, double click on the name, and I'm going to call that layer paint. All right, so I'm pretty much all set up. Each layer I can hide and show. I can lock. Okay, these are different lock options. If you hover over it, you can see what each separate lock option is. So I'll end up just locking the whole layer for the sketch so I don't accidentally paint over it and ruin the original sketch layer. All right, but we'll get to that in a minute. The paint layer is going to be a normal layer. We don't want it to be see-through, so I'll leave the opacity at 100%. And the white background layer is just going to be normal, the same. The sketch layer, though, we want to be able to see the paint through the sketch layer. And you might think I'll just take the opacity down so that you can see it, but watch what happens to my sketch lines when I bring the opacity down. It brings the opacity down for the entire image, but I want to keep those lines dark and then only see the paint through the white areas. So in order to do that, there's a great layer mode called multiply. And as things get closer to white, you can see the paint through it. Okay, so since that's in multiply mode, I can go to my paint layer, and I'll show you what's happening here. I'll go to my paintbrush. Okay, this is my eraser. This is my paintbrush. I'll go to my paintbrush. If I want to change the brush size, I can go here, change the brush type. I can also go to my brush palette and pick some specific ones there. Don't use these cheesy ones that everybody uses, kind of cliche. Let most of your creativity be in how you paint it and the colors you choose and things like that. Don't use like the grass brush and these weird kind of funky brushes, dune grass. Okay. A tip with painting, if you want to change the color, you can change the foreground color here by double clicking on it. Okay, or by just clicking on it. Okay, you can change the color up here. Notice it changes here as well when you change it. So you can use your sliders and this little color palette here. You can use your swatches and change the color that way. So most of the time I'll just double click on the foreground color here and change it. There's the different light, dark, tint, shade, brightness, and then there's also like the hue changes. Okay. To change the brush size, again, I can go up here and change it. I can go to my brushes palette over here and change it. A key command that's great for brushes is hitting the right square bracket to increase the brush size on your keyboard, and then the left square bracket to decrease your brush size on the keyboard. That's quick. That's a quick way to do it. Notice you can change the brush hardness and softness. And as you paint, notice you can see through that layer. I'm painting on the paint layer, but you can see through the white, and it doesn't show through the darker lines because the sketch layer is on multiply mode. Okay. Later on, I'll lock the sketch layer so I don't paint accidentally and ruin my sketch layer. But I just wanted to show you that. Before we paint, though, this isn't exactly white. My fingers are here, so I need to clean up this image first. Okay, so I am going to go to my sketch layer. I'm going to take my eraser tool, which works just like a brush. Notice up here in the tool options, I've got brush size, hardness, opacity, similar things to the paintbrush. I'm going to erase my fingers there. I'm just going to kind of go through this and clean it up. Okay, oops, I didn't mean to. Command Z there. I can Command Z or go back in my history over here because I screwed up erasing it right there. So I'm just going to kind of do that. Make my brush size a little bigger. Okay. All right. And then I want to get rid of this tint. So I can do that a number of ways. I can go to Image Adjustment, and I can go to Hue Saturation, take out the tint by bringing down the saturation, increase the lightness and darkness that way. That's not really what I want because that's going to lighten the black lines too. Nor do I want to change the hue. You're not going to notice the hue change when the saturation is all the way down. When the saturation is up, you'll see the hue change. Okay, but I'm not worried about that right now. If you did want to colorize the lines, you could hit colorize and then change the saturation and then color the lines. I don't want you to do that. I don't know why I showed you that, but I don't want you to do that. I want you to keep your lines black. So for this one, I'm going to take it off colorize. I'll bring the saturation all the way down and leave the lightness where it is. Okay, so we're good there. Another way to fix these grays and the rest of the smudges would be brightness and contrast. Okay, you can do it that way. Okay, that looks good. I'll go back in my history here. You could also do image adjust levels, and you can bring up the black point so the blacks are darker and bring down the white point so there's less grays up there in the white. This histogram is showing me there's a lot of light grays here. So what I do is I bring my white point down past those grays and it gets rid of those grays. And if my blacks aren't really black, then I'll bring my black point up this way. Okay, so that's making my sketch lines look still hand-drawn, but it gets rid of a lot of those smudges. Okay, so I'll hit OK. This is what I want you to do to clean up your sketch. All right? And then you can go through and begin painting on the paint layer. But remember, again, before you do, you need to lock your sketch layer. Okay, so I'm going to lock it there. And then to paint, I'll click on the paint layer. And, of course, I'm erasing right now. So I'm going to get rid of some of that green that I put on before. And then I can go back to my paintbrush, make the brush size smaller, and I could start painting in this way. Okay. You could do lots of stuff. You could be kind of loose with it. All right. Zooming in is nice when you paint because you can work on the finer details. All right, so I can take my paintbrush here, give some brown color to the hair there. Okay, and paint behind there. Okay, bring that in. I used to do a lot of comics this way or storyboards. There was a newspaper comic that I met that did it this way. It's a nice way to just add color to your sketches. And then I'm constantly adjusting the brush size. If I mess up, I can go back and fix that later. I can erase it. It's just a great thing to be able to do this in Photoshop because you can always undo it. Okay. All right, so I'm adding some hair color. If I wanted a harder brush, I can go here. Just remember the key commands. Left square bracket makes your brush smaller. Right square bracket makes it bigger. Okay. If you hold down shift square bracket, that'll make it softer. With the left square bracket, shift right square bracket makes it a harder edge brush. Okay, so you can kind of do a happy medium. Oops, Command Z. If you really mess up that last paint, just hit Command Z. I'll hit Command minus to zoom out. Command plus. If you hit the space bar, it'll give you the hand. Not the finger, but the hand. Hit the space bar and then click, and you can move your canvas around so you can stay zoomed in. So space bar, click, and drag. Okay, Command minus, Command plus, Command zero puts it all back into the frame. Remember when I say Command 2, the equivalent on a PC is control. All right, so Command plus, I want to work close like that. I'll hit the space bar and click and drag it around. Start painting again. You guys, give me some feedback in the course. Let me know if I'm going too fast, if I'm speaking clearly, so that I can just be a little bit better in my teaching. I've never done this before, so I want to make sure that you are getting all of this, okay? If you want to, after I begin, after I get a lot of these colors in, you could use a variation of colors. In fact, that's what I would suggest. I mean, you could do some flat colors. Depends on the style of coloring you're going for. You could be really loose and not stay within the lines. Just kind of add some watercoloring type of tint to the entire image. There's a lot of... I showed you some examples in the course, but you can color this a number of ways. Now, if you take that same color and then get a smaller brush, You can create some highlights in the hair. Okay. Oops, I want a softer brush. Okay. And I want a smaller brush. But you can create some highlights in the hair there. Like this. You can also... Well, that's nice. I like it. Okay. You can also... take a bigger brush here. Create more shadows, so I can take my color here, make it more dark. Okay. Oops. Maybe not that dark. Zoom in. Okay, so you can, I do want it darker there. Not that dark yet. Okay, oops. See what happens when you zoom out? It gets harder to control. This sketch was done from was taken from a photograph. It's probably better to do. I need to go back to my medium colors there. But the photograph was black all the way around the edges. So, you know, I could do away with the color. And I can go with a real dark. Make sure that brush is soft. Do a large size. And I could really kind of bring that image in. Just like it's, I don't know, just like it's kind of fading in from the dark background there. So there's a number of ways I can do this. Yeah. Just have fun with it. Okay? Think about what your book might be about. You know, if you want it to be, you know, more digital looking, you could, you know, kind of make it look a little pixely. Or if you wanted it to look more realistic, you could take some time and paint it more realistically. If you wanted to look like a comic, you can paint more flat. So think about that as you paint it. Again, if you don't like it, if you think you've totally failed, you can just come down here to the paint layer and delete the whole layer, but I wouldn't suggest doing that. I would suggest just hiding that paint layer and then just creating a new layer. Call it like paint 2. Okay, so you could even try different styles. And then if you don't like the one, you can go back to the original that you had. Okay, all right, so. That's an idea on how to color your sketches. This is kind of the approach that I want you to take for this book cover. But let me know if you have any questions, and give me some feedback if you could. There you go.